Yesterday, I did an awful lot of talking about the Scott DeWoz Archives book and not a lot of talking about literally anything else. So today, I'm gonna fix that. The first thing I want to touch on is the fact that it was Sid's birthday yesterday. He's 26 now, so welcome to the club, buddy. It's all downhill from here. It's been all downhill since I turned 20, to be honest with you. But hey, that's life. Second thing I want to address, I am indeed wearing the same shirt as yesterday. That's because I slept in it and then didn't get dressed today because I didn't go out to work, which might come back to bite me in the ass because I've only got a couple more days before I got to pay my rent. But we'll see, won't we? Third thing I want to address is you may have noticed since the start of year 11, the vlog titles have changed a little bit. The ones that are actually beneath the video. I got rid of the day number and just keep that in the description now, and then on the little date pop-up that appears right here. Or, sorry, like in the corner, wherever the hell it appears. Because I figured, you know, if say, a new person comes to the channel and they see that they've missed 3,500 days of stuff, they may not want to stick around and watch. But if they just see that, oh, this is a video from this day, then, you know, they're less likely to be turned away. So that's kind of why I did it. I did steal the idea from Steven Vlog. There's no secret, I stole a lot of ideas from Steven Vlog throughout the time that this channel has existed. But I have been thinking about it for a while, and I think the start of year 11 made sense, so I went ahead and did it. And then there was also the fact that a Nintendo Direct was announced for today. I really should have brought that up, shouldn't I? Well, it wasn't a Nintendo Direct. It was a Nintendo Direct mini partner showcase. And we are going to take the rest of this vlog to talk about the stuff that they showed in that.
I am one memory card error away from breaking this camera. It just happened twice while trying to film this. It's literally not moving. What is the issue it's having? I don't understand. Anyway, here's our direct. Let's get going. The first thing they showed, and probably the biggest section of this, was some Monster Hunter Rise Sunbreak. I know nothing about this. I don't super care for Monster Hunter. But I did play the demo for Sunbreak with Sean, Billy, and Sid a few days back, or like a week or so ago at this point. And I had a lot of fun with it, I gotta admit, but I just don't... I've never gotten super into the Monster Hunter franchise. But Sean was having a great time when he saw this. He was messaging our group chat saying, like, this is a big deal. I know you guys don't care for Monster Hunter, but they're adding so much cool stuff. And I'm just glad that Monster Hunter fans are getting a good game. They also just kind of revealed at the end that they're adding a ton of free updates throughout 2022 and into 2023. That is indeed a massive expansion. That is a good way to describe it. Next up, Nier Automata, the end of Yorah edition. I've never played Nier Automata, but it's always kind of interested me. I think 2B's character design is great. And this is an actual native Switch version. It's not a cloud version. It's actually coming directly to the Switch, which I kind of expected. Honestly, I thought that this game would be one that would come to the Switch eventually, and here it is. And I guess I'll actually finally get to play this game now. Next up was this puzzle game that didn't really interest me in the slightest. It looks like it belongs on the DS, which I thought was kind of cool. Like, the graphics at certain parts of it reminded me of the DS, but... Lorelei and Laser Eyes, very nice. Alright, now we get into some stuff that I really like the look of. Super Bomberman R2, for one. As far as I remember, Super Bomberman R was a launch title for the Switch, so 5 years later, we're finally getting a sequel to it, adding a bunch more features, and honestly, the main thing that I'm wondering about it is if they're gonna change the spine of the box, so that it actually it lines up with the rest of the Switch boxes, or if they're gonna keep it as just the logo, like the original one. I kinda want them to keep it as just the logo, because then it's just the Bomberman games that are going to be standing out. And this! Never played the Battle Network games, but Mega Man Battle Network Legacy Collection? Yeah, okay, I'm here for it. Honestly, just give us everything Mega Man ever. Which is kind of what they've been doing, isn't it? We got the Mega Man Legacy Collection, we got the Mega Man X Legacy Collection. Did we have a Mega Man Zero, maybe, Legacy Collection? I can't remember. And now we've got the Battle Network one, so I think we're gonna get, like, every Mega Man game. Just the fact that Battle Network is getting love, and GBA is getting love, that's really cool. And then a Pac-Man World remake!
been kidnapped.
Yeah, I'll take a Pac-Man World remake. This is honestly the a really good direct for a partner showcase. And this looks cute. It's the fox and the deer, but it's not because one's a wolf. I don't know, it just looks cute. It's a multiplayer, a co-op platformer game with a very cute art style. I'll take it. Monkey Island. That's a thing. I don't know anything about Monkey Island, and this art style really doesn't appeal to me, so this one didn't grab me. We got some more footage for Mario plus Rabbid Sparks of Hope. I'm actually super intrigued by this one. I never finished the first one. Oh god, he's called Sparks. That's why it's called Sparks of Hope, isn't it? Yeah, it looks like more of the original, but with some updated, like, tactics and stuff for the battles, so looks like a ton of fun. And some people are speculating that Rosalina is the villain. That'd be kind of cool. Oh, there'll also be a special showcase for it tomorrow, so hopefully I can catch that. They did, a little sizzle reel type thing. This looks like a mobile game. This is a train game. I mean, I will admit I like the look of the train game. I like trains. What was the next one? This one where you draw things? I don't know, I'm sure this stuff appeals to someone, but not to me personally. This guy. We got Sonic. Sonic Frontiers. I talked about a lot of Sonic Frontiers on this vlog channel recently. This shows us more than any of those trailers, any of those IGN videos did. For example, Green Hill Zone is in the game. I'll skip ahead so you can see. He goes through a warp gate thing, and then there it is. That's Green Hill Zone. What is the one before it? No, it's called a cyberspace. What is this? I don't know. City Escape, but that is Green Hill Zone again. It was this cute looking little Disney thing with a bunch of characters all together. I don't really get it. Like, I don't know. I don't truthfully understand what kind of game this is. I guess life simulation. Okay, cool. I don't get why this section is called Adventures on the Go, because it's the Switch. Everything on this console is on the go. Live Alive. Neat. I do want to get that, actually. And then some weird Harvest Moon looking thing. Minecraft. Minecraft Legends. Very neat. And then I think the entire time that this Dragon Quest trailer was on, I just talked about Rocket Slime. Here's our actual sizzle reel, I guess, because it's sizzling. They actually did show Fire Emblem Warriors 3 Hopes. That's not a partner game. Well, I guess technically Koei Tecmo made it, but it's a Fire Emblem game, you know? But whatever. They showed off a bunch of stuff we know is coming. Cloud version can go away. I don't care for cloud versions at all. Oh, Portal! Portal 1 and 2. Apparently this was announced previously, but I had forgotten, so I pogged really hard. Another farming life simulation game. We love those. And this one legitimately blew my mind. Persona. 3, 4, and 5 are coming to Switch. Good. Alright, yeah, I'm gonna be completely and perfectly honest with you. This was probably the best partner showcase we've ever had. Easily the best one. It was so much good content in here. Some of it I didn't really care for, but we got a ton of good stuff. The Pac-Man remake, the Sonic Frontiers gameplay and trailer, Persona, the Mega Man stuff, the Bomberman game. There was a lot. There was a ton of stuff in this. Couldn't have really asked for a better partner showcase, to be honest.
Now, would I have preferred a regular direct? Of course I would. I also just realized I stopped my microphone recording, so I guess we're going back to bad audio. Would I prefer a regular direct? Of course I would. Who wouldn't? But I think, for the time being, we got a pretty damn good partner showcase there instead of it. I still hope that we get a regular direct soon, because we are basically done with E3 season, but I kinda don't think it's happening at this point, and we'll have to wait until, like, September. But we'll see. And that is gonna be it for today. So thank you all for watching, stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.